Hello friends, myself Jyoti More, assistant professor from Swerys College of Pharmacy, Pandharpur. Today I have delivered the lecture on nutraceuticals and the different role of nutraceuticals or the benefits of nutraceutical in the different type of diseases. So firstly, what is meant by nutraceuticals? The nutraceutical is any substance that is a food or a part of food that provide the medical or health benefits, which is including the prevention and the treatment of a disease, which is promotion of a health. It is known as a nutraceuticals. It is in simple things, the nutraceuticals means it is nothing but a food, or it is a like a food, but which is used for prevention and the treatment of diseases, mainly for provide the medical and the health benefits, which is promote the health. Okay, so nutraceuticals, it was firstly discovered in 1989 by Stefan Defley, which is a founder chairman of a foundation for innovation in a medicine. So in 1989, nutraceuticals, it was firstly discovered. The meaning of nutraceutical, it is the two sentence or the two words, that is a nutrition and pharmaceuticals, and both are combined, then it is known as a nutraceuticals. Means nutraceuticals are mainly providing the nutritions. So in that sentence, apple a day keeps the doctor away. That means you take a nutraceuticals or you take a nutrient foods, that indicate that a day's keep away from the doctors. Means when you take a nutraceutical, so the no necessary for meet to the doctors. In that diagram, which indicate or that is difference between the drug and nutraceuticals. Though mainly the drug means the drug or substance which is used for the disease treatment, but the nutraceuticals which is mainly used for the health benefits. But when you combine with the drug and nutraceuticals, then which is mainly useful, it is the prevention of a disease. So both are necessary in your life, drug as well as a nutraceuticals. The mainly role of drug, it is used for the treatment of a disease, but the role of nutraceuticals is to provide the nutrient that may prevent the disease. Drug, which is treatment of a disease, and nutraceutical, which is a prevent of a disease. So, some of advantages and disadvantages of nutraceuticals are available. So, the advantages of nutraceuticals are, they are like substance or food, but not considered as a drug. Means is like same as a food, but not considered as a drug. So have a less or the few side effects. Means nutraceuticals having a few side effects. Second advantage, they are mainly used in prevention and improve the medical condition. Then they have a natural ingredients, dietary supplement to maintain or to balance the diet. Next, they enhance the overall health and well-being. Next advantage, they are available without prescription, means they are accessible and affordable. When you take a nutraceutical, there is not necessary to the prescription. Okay, it is the advantages of nutraceuticals. Then the sum of disadvantages of nutraceuticals are also present. First disadvantage is quality and regulatory issues. Means the nutraceuticals which are not 100% quality and 100% authentify or regulatory issues. So second, bioavailability. The bioavailability of nutraceutical is different as compared to the synthetic drugs. Then safety and interactions. Nutraceutical, some of interactions will be the occurs. So these are the disadvantages of nutraceuticals. Then the basic categories of nutraceuticals are available in the markets. In the categories, there are three categories of nutraceuticals are available. First is dietary supplements, second is herbal phytochemicals and nutrients. In the dietary supplements, example, probiotic, prebiotic, antioxidants and the sum of enzymes. Then herbals and phytochemicals, herbs or botanical products are used, which is act as a nutraceutical. In the nutrients, example, vitamin, minerals, amino acid and fatty acids. These three categories of nutraceuticals are available in the market. Then the market growth and the scope of nutraceuticals. Okay, first, The global nutraceuticals market is divided into the three following categories. Means the market of nutraceutical are divided into the three categories. First is functional food, second is functional beverages, and third is the dietary supplements. So one or any combination of substance like a minerals, amino acid, vitamins and herbs which is act as a nutraceuticals. Okay, then the types of products available in the markets. There are mainly three types of products which is available in the recently in a market. First, functional packaged food. Example, corn flakes, oats, Pediacure, Horlicks, Tiger Glucose Biscuit, Sunfist, Amul products and the Choco Flakes. Then, dietary supplements. In the dietary supplements, example is Glucose D, Nutrilite product, Herbal Life Protein Powder, Himalaya Pure Herbs. And last is the functional beverages. The beverages means it is nothing but a liquid formation or the drink formulations. In the functional beverages, example is aloe vera fiber juice, fruit juice, tropicana juice and other drinks. These are mainly three types of products which are available in the market. So, firstly the disease is a diabetes and the role of nutraceuticals in the diabetes. Recent year, the use of nutraceuticals and nutritional and natural in the therapeutics at a global level. Because of the conventional treatment options available as a synthetic drug does not meet properly the therapeutic needs for the treating the diabetes. But nutraceuticals or herbal drugs which is provided better therapeutic hope with a lesser side effect. Means the synthetic drugs which are produces a side effect. But herbal drugs or herbal formulation not produces or the less produces a side effects. So mainly three categories of nutraceuticals are used in the diabetes. First is nutrient, second herbals and third is the dietary supplements. In the nutritions, substance which established the nutritional functions such as vitamin, minerals, amino acid and fatty acids. Meaning the diabetes which is necessary to take a nutrients, that is you take a vitamins, minerals, amino acids and fatty acids. Second is herbals. In the herbals, mainly herbs or botanical products as a concentrate and the extract. Means the extract of herb and the concentrate of herb which is also act in a diabetes. Next, dietary supplements. In the dietary supplements, the reagents derived from other serving specific functions such as in the dietary supplements mainly involve sport nutrition, weight loss supplements and the meal replacement. So, in the next PPT, the different types of nutraceuticals are used in the treatment of a diabetes in or the benefits of a nutraceuticals over the diabetes. First nutraceutical is antioxidant, second vitamin C, third calcium and vitamin D, fourth vitamin E, fifth carbohydrate, six fats, seven fibers, eight chromium, nine magnesium and ten proteins. So step by step or individually nutraceuticals and its role of benefits. First nutraceutical is antioxidants. The role of antioxidants and the benefit of antioxidants in diabetes such as a plenty supply of dietary antioxidants may prevent or delay the diabetes complications including the renal and neural dysfunction by providing protection against the oxidative stress. Mainly the role of antioxidant in diabetes which is reduces or prevent the complications which is mainly present in the diabetes and reduces the oxidative stress. Then second nutraceutical is vitamin C. The vitamin C which is also known as the ascorbic acid. The role of ascorbic acid in a diabetes, it is a chain breaking antioxidants, scavenging property and prevent the propagation of chain reaction that could otherwise lead to the reduction in protein glycation. Mainly the role of vitamin C which is prevent or reduce protein glycation and the protein glycation is reduced then reduce the glucose level. In animal, vitamin C also reduces a diabetes induced
Sorbitol. Accumulation means in animals, vitamin C which are reduces the accumulation of a sorbitol, and lipid peroxide in the erythrocytes. These are the role of vitamin C. Then calcium and vitamin D. The role of calcium and vitamin D in diabetes, high calcium intake act as a protective to develop the diabetes. And it act by suppressing the secretion of parathyroid hormones, and calcium and vitamin D helps to preserve the insulin sensitivity. The main role of calcium and vitamin D is to preserve the insulin sensitivity. Then vitamin E. The vitamin E is essential fat soluble vitamin which is mainly used for increase the frequency of diabetes, which is when you take a vitamin E it is a low level. But the vitamin E which is mainly act as a antioxidants, and the role of antioxidant is oxidative stress is reduced. Then carbohydrates. The carbohydrates are the energy providing substances and greatest effect on the glucose level. Mainly carbohydrates which are decreases the glucose level in the diabetes patient. Then fat. In the fats, the high fat diets can damage the glucose tolerance and promote the obesity and cause the heart diseases. But some of these fats which are also benefit to the diabetics patient, such as monounsaturated fats such as olive oil, peanut oils are beneficial effect on the glycemic management. Means the fat which is some of disadvantages also occurs, but the sum of advantages occurs in the diabetic patients. Mainly the fat omega 3 fatty acids, which is unsaturated fatty acid. These are fatty acids which are present in the fish, and the role of omega 3 fatty acid is reduces the triglycerides without disturbing the glycemic control. The main role of fat to maintain or to manage the glycemic reactions. Okay, it is the role of fat in the diabetes. Then fibers. The fibers are also against in the chronic diseases, as well as they can control the glycemic metabolism. The sum of food which is containing the fibers like fruits and the vegetables. So the fiber containing the fruits and vegetables, which is also act as a nutraceuticals, mainly used in the treatment of a diabetes. Then chromium, these are the supplement increase the insulin sensitivity and improve the glucose tolerance in the patient type 2 diabetes. The main role of chromium to increase the insulin sensitivity. Then magnesium. The magnesium, it is also rich diet with decrease the risk of a diabetes and improve in the insulin sensitivity. Then proteins. The proteins stimulate the insulin secretion, but excessive intake should be avoided, lead to the pathogenesis of diabetic nephropathy. The main role of protein is used to control the cholesterol level. The different protein supplements are used to control the diabetes, such as liquid protein and the protein powders. The rich source of proteins which are used in the diabetes, soy, rice and the eggs. So these are the 10 types of nutraceuticals which are also useful in the diabetic treatment, and these are the role and the health benefits of nutraceuticals. So the second disease, which is a cardiovascular disease. The majority of the cardiovascular disease can be prevented and the controlled. Okay, low intake of fruits and vegetables is connected with the mortality in the CVS. A diet rich in fruits and vegetables helps in controlling the CVS. And nutraceuticals in the form of antioxidant, dietary fibers, omega 3 polyunsaturated fatty acids, vitamin and minerals, along with exercise for prevention and the treatment of a CVS. Mainly the cardiovascular diseases are prevented and controlled, but not a cure when you take a nutraceuticals. And for this prevention and the treatment of CVS, we take a more and more nutraceuticals. In that nutraceuticals mainly involve the omega 3 fatty acids, dietary fibers, antioxidant, vitamins and minerals, but along with the exercise for a good prevention and the treatment of a diseases. Next part, the following types of nutraceuticals are used in the treatment of a cardiovascular diseases. Example, phytosterol, polyphenol, flavonoids, spirulina and soy nutrients, alpha tocopherol, curcumin, omega 3 fatty acid, tomato and garlics. These nutraceuticals which are helpful for the cardiovascular diseases. So next PPT I will explain the use and the role of these nutraceuticals in the cardiovascular diseases. First, phytosterol. So the what is meant by phytosterol? The plant sterol known as the phytosterols means the which type of sterols are present in the plant, it is known as a phytosterol. And this present in the plant products including the fruits, vegetables, okay. And phytosterol are the similar to the cholesterol. The phytosterol which is inhibit the intestinal absorption of cholesterol but do not affect on the HDL and the VLDLs. Okay, the phytosterol which is also helpful to the cardiovascular diseases. The main role of phytosterol which are inhibit the intestinal absorption of a cholesterol. Okay, then polyphenol. In the polyphenols include the flavonoids and the phenolic acids. These are mainly present in the fruits, vegetable, legumes, in beverages produced from the plant products such as tea, coffee, wine and the cocoas. Means the polyphenols which are present in the different fruits and the different types of vegetables as well as the different types of drinking materials. The main role of polyphenol in the CVS, polyphenol affect to the plasma lipid concentration and polyphenol exert the anti-atherosclerotic effect in initial stages of atherosclerosis developments. Means the polyphenol which is mainly act as anti-atherosclerotic effect. Okay, then flavonoids. The flavonoids are also present in the all plant parts. In that flavonoids it contains the phytoestrogens which have an antioxidant activity, influence lipoprotein metabolism and increase the vascular reactivity. Flavonoids catalyze lipid oxidation, inhibit the platelet aggregation. The mainly role of flavonoids which are inhibit the platelet aggregation. Next is alpha tocopherol. The alpha tocopherol, it is also known as a vitamin E, it is the main fat soluble antioxidants. Alpha tocopherol promote the oxidation of lipoproteins. Mainly role of alpha tocopherol is promote the oxidation of lipoproteins. Then spirulina and the soy nutrients. So the spirulina is a rich source of protein, vitamin, minerals, carotenoids. The rich source of spirulina is contain protein, vitamin, minerals and carotenoids. But the spirulina is supplementary alter the blood lipid profiles. Then soy products are the rich in polyunsaturated fatty acid, fibers, vitamins and minerals. They have a low saturated fat content. So spirulina and the soy nutrients which is also helpful in the CVS disorders. Then curcumin. The main role of curcumin is prevent the cardiac hypertrophy and heart failure. Its long-term use decrease the serum lipid peroxide and the total cholesterol. Curcumin the mainly role for prevent the cholesterol level. Then omega 3 fatty acid. This is most commonly prescribed supplement. Omega 3 fatty acid which are the most commonly used and prescribed supplement in the cardiovascular diseases. They decrease the inflammation and platelet aggregation. They cause the vasodilation and improve the myocardial function. Means omega 3 fatty acids which is also useful in the CVS. Then tomato. In that tomato which containing 1 carotenoids such as lycopenes, these are present in the red fruits and vegetables like papaya, tomatoes and watermelon. The role of lycopene is to consumption of lycopene which reduces a myocardial infarction and angina pectoris. Means mainly prevent the tomato which also prevent angina pectoris. And lycopene is one of the most antioxidants which is prevent the CVS. Then garlic. The garlic is the significant food and medicinal importance. Garlic having an antiplatelet activity and inhibit the platelet aggregations. Enhance the vasodilation and the fibrolysis. Hence, it is useful in the CVS. So, these 9 types of nutraceuticals which is used in the CVS disorders. It is the role and the health benefits of these different types of nutraceuticals in the CVS. Then, the nutraceuticals which are used in the cancer. First, chestnut. Second, berries. Third, soy, garlic, green tea, grape seed, ginseng, tomatoes and dietary fibers. These 9 types of nutraceuticals are used in the prevention and the control of the cancer. So, one by one I will explain the role and the benefits of a nutraceutical. First, chestnut. So, the chestnut which are extract, which is mainly act as a antioxidants which are protective against the gastric cancer and a mild protective effect against the prostate cancer and the breast cancer. So, the chestnut, main role of chestnut which is produces a negative effect on the growth of gastric cancer cells. Okay, means chestnuts which are prevent the growth of a cancer cell. Then berries. In that berries, the blueberries, blackberries and strawberries are a good source of antioxidant and phenolic compounds. The mainly role of these all berries are prevent the growth of a cancer cell. So which berry which is act as a which type of a cancer? First is a blueberries which is mainly effect on the breast cancers. Means blueberry which are more prevent the growth of cancer cell in the breast. And in the breast cancer, blueberries it is a nutraceuticals which are mainly used in the breast cancer. And strawberries which is prevent the chronic diseases and which is used in the different types of cancers. Third is the soy. The soy contains isoflavones which is reduces the risk of breast cancer and particularly among the postmenopausal women. The soy which is also act on the breast cancer. Then garlic. The garlic is the sulfur containing active compounds which is protective against the onset and progression of a different types of a cancer. So, the garlic which is also act as a treatment of a cancer. Garlic in a different form including the garlic oil has been protective against the liver cancer. Garlic which is act on the different types of cancer, but garlic oil which is mainly useful against the liver cancer. Then green tea. The green tea contains a polyphenols which prevent the advancement of tumor cell and also used for the cell death. Mainly green tea which is useful for the destroy and the death of a cancer cell. Next, grape seed. The grape seed is effective in the prevention of UV light induced cancer. The grape seed extract also decreases the risk of cell carcinoma as it contains the polyphenols and inhibit the lung cancer. Means the grape seeds which are also containing the polyphenols and due to the presence of polyphenols which are inhibit the different types of cancers and decreases the risk in the carcinoma cell. Okay, then ginseng. The ginseng is also used as a medicinal plant. Belongs to the genus Panax. It is used to prevent the different types of cancers. The main role for the ginseng is for the research activity in the cancer treatment. Mainly for the research which will be performing for prevent the cancer, the mainly plant is used which is a ginseng. Then tomatoes. We know tomato which contain a one antioxidants which is a lycopene which is also useful in the CVS and it is also useful in the cancer treatment. The lycopene is chemo preventive against the cancers including prostate cancer, gastric cancer, breast and the lung cancer. Means the tomato which are mainly used for the treatment of various types of cancers such as prostate, gastric, breast and the lung cancer. Okay. So, last nutraceutical in the cancer treatment is dietary fibers. In the dietary fibers, the rich diet intake which is reduces the risk of breast cancer. When you take a dietary fiber foods which is risk or prevent the risk of breast cancer. And in that fibers, you have to take mainly broccoli, cabbage, cauliflowers and the greens. That is the green vegetables. When you take a green vegetables and fiber containing the fruits, so which is to prevent the risk of a cancer. So these type of nutraceuticals are used in the cancer treatment. So the next part, which is nutraceuticals used in the irritable bowels and gastrointestinal diseases. So first is curcumin, aloe vera, garlic, honey, probiotic, vitamins, carbohydrate diets and non-starch polysaccharides. So one by one I will explain. So first is curcumin, mainly the curcumin which are traditionally used as antioxidants. So in the role of irritable bowel syndrome and gastrointestinal diseases, the main role of curcumin is, the curcumin is a phytochemical and natural member of gingiberaceae ginger family, is derived from rhizomes. So the rhizomes of curcumin, which is useful in the treatment of irritable bowel syndromes. The curcumin has been used in the both Ayurvedic and traditional system. The main role of curcumin is anti-inflammatory activity and reduces the mucosal injury. Okay, so the curcumin produces a modulation of kappa B kinase activity and mainly used in the treatment of a peptic ulcer. The gastrointestinal diseases and irritable bowel syndrome means the different types of ulcers are present in your body, and these ulcers which are prevented by different types of nutraceuticals are used. Second, aloe vera. The aloe vera, it contains the bioactive compounds like salicylate, luteols, campestrol, alloctin A. These are bioactive compounds which is mainly present in the aloe vera. So the role of aloe vera in the gastrointestinal diseases such as prevent the stress induced gastric ulceration and wound healing property. Mainly aloe vera which is act as a wound healing property. Then garlic. The garlics are used in the cancer treatment as well as it is useful in the gastrointestinal diseases. The role of garlic is, the garlic oil which prevent the ethanol induced gastric injury, and this protective effect has recognized for its antioxidant activity. For example, when a person take a more ethanol, they can cause the injury in the gastrointestinal tract. So this gastrointestinal tract injury is decreased by using a garlic oil, the persons which are take a more ethanols. Okay, then garlic oil decreases the lipid peroxide and decreases the antioxidant enzyme level. It is the role of garlic. Then honey. The honey, it is a natural remedy in the various part of the world. Honey used to stimulate the tissue growth and enhance the revitalization and minimize the scar formation. The main role of honey in the gastrointestinal diseases is minimize the scar formations and stimulate the tissue growth. When any parts of injury which causes the tissue death, this tissue death or increase the tissue growth by using the honey. Also, the role of honey is inhibit the growth of hydropyroli, the main etiological agents in the gastrites and peptic ulcer and gastric adenocarcinoma. Means the growth of pyroli, which are also inhibit, are decreased by using the honey. Then prebiotics. So the prebiotic means it is a live bacteria that are similar to beneficial normally beside in the intestine. Okay, the prebiotic, it is a live bacteria. And these prebiotics are available in the dietary supplements like a capsule, tablets, powder or the food like yogurts, fermented and unfermented milk, as well as some juices and the soy beverages which are also containing the prebiotics. And the prebiotics which are useful in the treatment of a gastric ulceration present in your gastric tract. So prebiotic, which is also useful in the irritable bowel syndromes and gastrointestinal diseases. Next, the vitamins. The mainly vitamins are A and D, which is main role in the irritable bowel syndrome. Then carbohydrate diets. The carbohydrate diets, the specific carbohydrate diets which are allow the intake of only monosaccharides.
and the completely avoid the disaccharides and polysaccharides, because means when you carbohydrate diets, you take only monosaccharides and completely avoid the disaccharide and polysaccharides, because they remains undigested and unabsorbed in the digestive tracts and lead to the overproduction of yeast and bacteria, which ultimately cause the intestinal injury. Means a patient which are suffering from the irritable bowel syndrome completely avoid the polysaccharides and the monosaccharide diets. Only take a monosaccharide. Okay? Means only take a monosaccharide carbohydrates, which is helpful for controlling the bowel syndrome and controlling the injury in the intestinal injury. Then non-starch polysaccharide. In the non-starch polysaccharides, it is also act as a dietary fibers, and these are obtained from the various natural sources, which is useful and it is also therapeutic against the inflammation and humin related problems. So the non-polysaccharides used in the gastrointestinal tract disorders, means the different type of non-starch polysaccharides are also useful in the irritable bowel syndrome. So this type of nutraceuticals are mainly used to prevent in the gastrointestinal diseases, mainly for the peptic ulcer and the intestinal injury. So today I have completed the four diseases and the role of nutraceuticals in a four diseases, such as first is diabetes, second is CVS, that is the cardiovascular diseases, then cancer, and then irritable bowel syndrome and gastrointestinal diseases. So in that topic only involve the basic information and the role and the benefits of herbs or the benefits of nutraceuticals in a different types of diseases. Thank you.